Hurry up, Cody. Iraqi freedom's gonna be over by the time we're done.
Shut up, Chris.
So, Heavy, bro, what do you have in these?
Hell if I know.
I'm bringing my whole life with me, dude. I can't remember what I packed.
Hey, thanks for the help, by the way.
Don't mention it.
What about you, like your gun and grenades and fun stuff?
Oh, don't give it to me once I'm deployed.
Sounds like fun to me. So where are you, like, actually going, you know?
Dude, Iraq. What rock have you been living under?
I mean, for, like, you know, training. Duh.
I don't know. Georgia or something?
Cool. I was just wondering. You know, lucky they don't let 16-year-olds like me into the army. Because I'll clap you in push-ups, boy.
Yeah, right. You in what chest?
No, it's not all in the chest, man. Like, have you seen these shoulders?
Yeah, if I squint hard enough, I can.
Okay, very, very, very funny. I'll have all your gym stuff now. So when you get back, I'm going to be cut to the bone, baby. Might even hop on steroids.
Oh, please don't. I don't need a big meatball pushing me around in a wheelchair.
Set me.
Hey! Whoa! Yo, put me down! Put me down! Put me down! Yo, put me down.
I'll let it slide this time, punk. Just get it all out of your system before I come back in a wheelchair. Mom's probably going to put me in a nursing home, dude.
True that, Sergeant.
Hey, that's private to you.
Whatever.
All right, let's load up.
Why did he sign up for the army anyway? Yeah, I mean, most people I talk to don't even know why we're fighting, except that we're just fighting terrorism. Do we really need to occupy a whole country just to squash some bugs?
Well, no matter how stupid the whole operation is, I can't stand to see other people die for my country. Even if the so-called cause is more of just an excuse.
I mean, that's fair. I just wish you thought about it more.
I mean, Cody, there isn't much keeping me here other than you. I'm sick of my life. I'm sick of splitting my time between Mom and Granddad with their money and pride, and Dad with his pitiful midlife crisis. I'm sick of waking up, showing up to school, barely passing, working at that godforsaken kiosk at the mall every day, hitting a lift, and wondering why nothing in my life ever changes for good. Something's gotta give.
But how is going off to a war gonna fix that? Will getting your legs blown off give you meaning? I mean, will dying for a career politician who doesn't give two shits about you finally help you fill that void?
Damn it, Cody, I've already made up my mind. What do you want me to tell the United States Army? I'm sorry, my younger brother made me sad, so count me out.
I don't know.
Maybe you can't accept that I want to go fight, and that you throwing a little temper tantrum isn't enough to keep me here. Once I leave this stinking pit, I will never look back.
But all I know is the kind of purpose that you're looking for does not come from a war. Burning gasoline can't give you direction, and blood isn't a prescription for meaninglessness. And all you're doing right now is trading one war for another. Just fight the right one.
You don't know what's best for me. I know my thoughts, and you don't, so that's the end of it.
Then why won't you accept the truth? Stay here and hold your ground, man. There are too many people who are just like you, who are dead, because they picked the wrong fight. You have so much left to win here. If you go over there and die, all you'd leave is your blood on the sand. Those people are not your enemies. But you are. I love you, man. Like, I just care about you. And I just want to see you win, even if I'm just your brother. Well, no matter what battle you pick to fight, just win it. Even if it's just for me, okay? See ya.
Thank you.
Come on, guys, come on. Liven it up. Go over the top.
Beautiful. Nice. Good.